When Chris Ross signed on as an assistant buyer in a department store 31 years ago, he thought that would be the ticket to European buying trips and the hunt for luxury brands. As it turns out, things didn't go exactly as planned. And for hundreds of specialty retailers everywhere, that's the good news.
This one company, Ivy's, which was a department store at the time, came to my campus and interviewed, and they were showing London, Hong Kong, all these different opportunities to travel. I took the job because the offer was there, and little did I know, it was really just a department store based in Charlotte. Ended up in the China Crystal Silver department, and specifically the silver as an assistant buyer. I went to the trainer and I said, oh, I understand this could lead to London, and he just looked at me like, I think you were sold a bill of goods. Stuck with it for about 9 months. Decided to put together a group of vendors that I knew that I could interview in New York, flew up to New York and interviewed, and they, at the age of 22, all kind of laughed at me and said, right, you know, good luck, come back in 3 years. The only one that didn't was Baccarat. They had a position in Florida. I saw Baccarat, I saw Florida, took the job, got a U-Haul, got down to Florida. For the next 4 months, the showroom I was working for failed to pay me. It was a chance for me to sort of reevaluate and find strength inside myself.
Even now, across a long career of product and design discoveries, it's the thrill of the hunt that keeps Chris energized and in perpetual pursuit of what's new and next.
It's fun to find things and bring them to people. I'm sensitive to the fact when I make a commitment to a vendor that not only do I have the showroom space for it, but do my reps have the face time to present the line properly. I think by having that philosophy, it's why I've had Baccarat, you know, certain lines for 30 years. One of my greatest pleasures is to watch a rep who's been with me maybe 6 months, a year, and to watch them sort of take on things that I've taught them and just really engage and really get that confidence level. I think they see the passion I have in them and they return it back to me in sales.
What would happen if a sales organization doing business in a global franchise with ultra-premium brands made grassroots integrity the ultimate measure of its success? It's been happening for more than 30 years, right here.
In my particular situation, I'm often told, Chris, your integrity is what I'm most impressed with. I have customers now where I'm working with the third generation of the same family. I see us evolving, I see our customer base evolving, loyal to our existing base, but still looking for new opportunities. It's a people business, and that's what I love about it.